back onto the Matthew Hall Show, February 2011. Yes, the first show got more than one viewer, so I was allowed to make another edition. Well, this month, the Middle East saw more political unrest as major demonstrations took place in Egypt. But do not worry, people of Britain, Tony Blair has been dispatched to deal with the problem. The human race took another step closer to insanity, with a film about Justin Bieber's life so far. In the film, we see Justin as a baby, trying to find somebody to love, talking about this one time, and trying to make you smile. The most observant of you will notice that this video looks a little different to the previous one, but I bet you can't figure it out, can you? Well, before we get really stuck into the news, I'll give you a clue. The biggest television controversy of the month was related to the return of the 500 million global viewer phenomenon that is Top Gear back on the BBC. Controversy was caused over comments made about the Mexicans, with Richard Hammond saying that the Mexicans are lazy, feckless, flatulent and overweight. With Clarkson also adding that the Mexican ambassador was unlikely to be watching the programme because he was asleep. Now, bearing in mind that the Mexican ambassador has probably not stopped watching British-made videos since that episode of Top Gear was released, I am not going to say anything else in case he's watching this. The issue was even discussed in Mexican Parliament. The only thing I can say is, that must have been a really slow news day. Should we talk about how Mexicans are going to America? No, let's discuss this Top Gear and its offensive comments about us. Just like Simon Cowell can control time, you know, like on Britain's Got Talent, when he said a few years ago, we shall find time. It now appears that Top Gear can control global politics. Forget about the army taking control of Egypt. Let's send Top Gear in there to sort it out. That's money. We'll sort it out much more quickly. Personally, I think people should lay off. This series of Top Gear was probably one of the best in recent times, so keep up the good work, boys. Also this month, it's been announced that the classic 1960s TV show Thunderbirds is going to be making a comeback on British television. Finally! Original Thunderbirds creator Jerry Anson will also be in charge of the new series. He said that this series will be very different to when it was in the 1960s. I've seen a sneak preview and he is not kidding.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go.
Yeah, that's different, all right. Now, the royal wedding is fast approaching and the hype around the country is building. Prince Harry has been announced as Prince William's best man and has been told to organise the stag do. Well, we can all safely assume that's going to end in disaster. Also, merchandising companies are trying every trick in the book they can to sell merchandise related to a royal wedding. One fashion company has even announced that their new Kate Middleton dress range has doubled their overall profits so far this year. I would just like to point out that it isn't actually her dress, you stupid people. Somebody has just stuck her name on them in order to try and sell their dresses. So, unfortunately, people of Britain, I must say, and I must be the first person to announce this, those are not dresses. Get that into your head. In fact, there's so much tat and souvenirs running around about the royal wedding that the Metro newspaper is running a contest to find the strangest merchandise you can find. How about related to a royal wedding? I've done a bit of searching and I've come across a few strange items myself. For example, a royal wedding sellotape dispenser. Some royal wedding 3D glasses, and royal wedding rabbit food on sale at your local souvenir shop. Now, people of Britain, how's this for an unusual story? Grandfather is reunited with car 3 years after leaving it in a car park. It's both weird and very heart-touching all at the same time. The man in question is now in his 80s, and unfortunately due to his health, he could not remember where he had left his car. What I find interesting, surely in this day where we can track cars by their registration plates, this car should have been found a lot quicker than it actually was. What's even more amazing is, in this time of economic difficulties, that car was left for 3 years with a credit card on the dashboard. I mean, who didn't spot it and at least try and steal it? But you can imagine, how lonely was that credit card? Lonely, I'm so lonely, I have nobody by my own. I didn't just do that, did I? The car itself only became noticed by police because they noticed how dirty it was. But hang on a minute, surely on that basis, most cars in Britain would be treated as suspicious. Especially on my street. Very dirty cars along here. And now it's time, as we're halfway through the show, for the Facebook break. I still have not got a button to activate the Facebook break with, but for this show, what I'm going to do is I'm going to imagine there's a big button just here. So, you have 20 seconds to update and check your Facebook status, starting from now. To find terrorists has been announced. Rodents trained to sniff out terrorists at airports. Yes, that's right, don't let the dogs out and burn those full body scanners, as these mice will find the bomb. Imagine the announcers at the airport. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain patient with us while Danger Mouse checks your luggage. Would everybody please leave the plane? The mice have found some suspicious looking cheese. Apparently the mice hide inside detectors, and this is how one expert described it. It looks like a metal detector or full body scanner, but one side of it houses three concealed cartridges, each containing eight specially trained mice. Could this story get any more stranger and funnier? Yes it can. Apparently the mice have to work 4-hour shifts. Next they'll be demanding a minimum wage, maternity leave, and setting up their own unions. And going on strike. You'll hate it when airlines shut down. Imagine if the mice went on strike. Ladies and gentlemen, we apologise for the inconvenience caused by the mice strike, but we have employed ants to do their job for them. Yeah, this is part of the show that will appear now and again, where I get to show you part of a major video I'm working on, or a small video, or something that I've caught on camera in the last few days or weeks that I want to show to you. Most of these I make outside of Pulse TV. Now, just before Christmas, I finished making my A2 media coursework production piece. It was to create a horror movie trailer, and I want to share the finished piece with you now. So here is my A2 media coursework production piece horror movie trailer. Enjoy. We'll be right back.
Hide and hope.
Captions to it, and I judge which one is the best one and announce winner at the end of my next show. Firstly, congratulations to last month's winner, Mike Rose 94, who posted this caption to this picture last month. So for this month, here is your picture. Let's see what you can all come up with this month. The March edition of the show should be out on Monday the 28th of March, but please do keep checking the Pulse TV website for future updates on this. I will try and keep to that date, but as I explained last show, it's not always possible due to me being an A-level student, and also I've got quite a busy month ahead. I hope you've enjoyed the show. So from me, Matthew Hall, until next month, it's goodbye for now. Bye bye.